Armed forces around the world achieve some of the highest fitness levels around due to the strenuous and often dangerous nature of their work. Pilots, for instance, face the constant risk of passing out mid-flight due to the high speeds they reach when flying, a condition known as G-LOC, or gravity-induced loss of consciousness. G-force is a measure of acceleration in multiples of 9.8 meters per second squared, more commonly known as the gravitational force of Earth. It can be experienced in simple ways, like suddenly accelerating or braking in a car, where your body is pushed backward or forward, respectively. In the context of pilots, they can experience G-forces in three dimensions due to the nature of flying. G-forces affecting pilots can be categorized into linear, radial, and angular forces. Linear G-forces relate to changes of speed in a straight line, whereas radial G-forces relate to changes in direction, such as sharp dives or turns. Angular G-forces are experienced due to a combination of changes in speed and direction. The impact of G-force is felt heavily on the body's moving parts, including organs and bodily fluids that can slosh around inside a pilot's body. The adverse effects of G-forces include reduced vision, blackouts, heightened heart rate, and elevated blood pressure. Extreme G-forces that last for prolonged periods can result in G-LOC, particularly during high-speed ascents, where blood may pool in the lower portions of the body, depriving the brain of oxygen and causing pilots to lose consciousness. In order to increase their threshold for G-LOC, pilots are routinely subjected to artificially created high G-force scenarios with the help of human centrifuges, which simulate the extreme conditions pilots experience in flight. Although humans can survive high G-forces for short intervals, pilots are trained to sustain up to 9 Gs, while stunt pilots often push their limits to 12 Gs. The average untrained citizen can handle no more than 5 Gs before passing out, although it's uncommon for most people to be in a situation that would trigger such high levels of G-force. It is possible on certain roller coasters, and an individual's physical fitness also impacts their threshold for passing out due to G-force. One of the methods to reduce the impact of G-forces hinges on reducing the motion of moving parts in the body. This principle means that by making independent parts move synchronously with the accelerating system, the adverse effects can be reduced. For pilots, this involves consistent training and wearing specially designed suits that compress the body with inflatable bladders, keeping blood flowing uninterrupted to the brain and maintaining a steady respiratory system. Civilians are generally advised to wear helmets and securely fasten their seatbelts to mitigate the effects of G-forces experienced when riding motorcycles or during car rides. While the thrill of acceleration can be exciting, it's crucial to reduce the hazardous impact of G-forces and avoid losing consciousness at all costs. If you enjoyed this video, we'd love to hear from you in the comments section. Your feedback not only supports us, but also helps our channel reach more viewers and continue to grow.